So what's happening in the background right now is the formation of the barrio committees here at Ajuri village in Omoro district. The prominent issue has been the songs, the traditional songs that are being played on the air. According to the LOC 5 Omoro district, he was called this morning by the National Barrio Committee to stop these songs. But the people are arguing that in actually culture, songs are used to vent grief.
The leaders have declined the request to remove all the traditional songs that are being sung from the airwaves.
It is culturally in order that the Acholi people and the people of Northern Uganda have different ways of mourning and expressing what is within their hearts. And one of them is through songs.
The Omoro District LOC 5 chairperson, Okello Douglas Peter Okawo, who is the interim chairperson of the local barrio committee, says they are all in support of the traditional songs.
We are also, as agreed today by members of the committee, the local organizing committee, that our artist also needs to compose a song of the good things that he has done, so that those good things become a learning experience for the leaders who are holding office now, for the leaders who will come after those ones who are holding office now, and for the young generation.
The Puranga Cultural Prime Minister Mawa Francis insists that the people of Acholi and Lango should be left to mourn in their cultural ways.
Acholi come out with song for a specific problems which happens in the community. They don't sing song anyhow. Song has a meaning.
With bitterness boiling during the barrio meeting in Ajuri village, renowned musician Romeo Odong also says the songs will help the bereaved to heal.
We as the Acholi people, or the Luo people, as a way of provoking reactions, we use songs and we use music, drama and dance as a way of keeping history, and that is to preserve, to learn from the past and preserve the future. We use music. Music is a tool. And I believe people react to situations differently.
Olanya also left the construction of a multi-billion house midway.
The house that you see in the background is a multi-billion project that was started by the former Speaker of Parliament. The people here believe that the government of Uganda should step in and ensure that the construction is completed before the barrio.
When completed, the magnificent storied building is expected to generate revenue.
Yet in mind that within this year, this building will be fully completed and it will be able to occupy, and other activities will take place within the same place. But he passed on before completion.
The people of Omoro also request the government to put on hold all by-election plans. The Anglican bishop for the Diocese of Northern Uganda, Godfrey Luom, is among the religious leaders who have taken it upon themselves to pray for Uganda during these mourning days.
Prepare our hearts and our manners as well to receive the people who are coming to stand with us at a time like this. And more importantly, to give our brother a decent send-off. And then life will continue after his burial, and then what needs to be discussed or done can be done when people are much more calm and when he has rested.
The local burial committee is working hand-in-hand with the National Burial Committee. Joseph Omagor for the news in Omoro District.